Mr. Rutledge.
Well, good evening, everyone, and thank you to the Roswell Women's Club for hosting this great event. And thank you to Mr. Herter for moderating, and also a big thanks to all of you who've come out to be part of this process. And to the Roswell Women's Club, I appreciate you being trailblazers that are blazing a path for my daughter to someday walk through here in Roswell. But let me begin with who I am not. I am not a career politician, as many of you have already attested to. I am not one who participated in the Roswell political circle. I'm not even a person who is a single issue candidate. I'm not a traffic or density expert, as most of us are not. But let me tell you who I am. I am a husband, a father of five, four of them who live in Roswell, a grandfather with one who lives in Roswell, a lover of Jesus and great baseball, but not necessarily in that order. I'm a veteran of the First Persian Gulf War. I am a servant leader with an eye to the future. I pray that I'm a visionary who cares about my children's and grandchildren's future and yours also. I've been involved in the community here for many years through sports, with my kids at their schools, and also through church and volunteering. But it's time for leadership that is honorable, one who will serve the citizens of this great city, and also who will work to bring back a oneness that we need in this city and eliminate and reduce some of this divisive talk that we've been having. So I will tell you this. It begins with vision. It begins with leadership. Where there is no vision, the people will perish. And we're at a crossroads right now in Roswell where we need vision that not only is for today, but it's for the next 50 years. Thank you.
Sean.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, Mr. Herter, for moderating this, and thank all of you for coming and being a part of this, and I'd like to thank all of you up here on the platform for a wonderful night. And thank you for hearing our vision for Roswell. And I want to bring up one point with my son. I've shared this campaign with him, and we've spent a lot of quality time together. He's a 16-year-old Roswell High School student, hopefully representing Georgia or the Governor's Honors Program here soon. But one of the favorite parts of the campaign has been our late night stops on Saturday night, because, you know, with all the traffic, you can't put signs out during the day without almost being run over. So we've been making Saturday night stops at IHOP and Waffle Houses. And here's something he said that's been motivating me. And here's, and I quote, "These are the qualifications of a city council member: compassion, leadership, and a servant heart. All of the other details will work themselves out, because when you care about the people, the city, and their quality of life, there's not much wrong you can do." What that means is service before self. It means leadership that will be honorable, but again, it will be service before self, and it will be someone who will work to truly unite this city. And that is something I will commit to do for you, work for you, just like I have been out and my son has been out canvassing over almost 4,000 houses by foot. We will work that hard for you in Roswell. Thank you very much.
Thank you.